Shibava song, Shepherd of a song,
Savior of a song, Lover of a song.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome.
Merciful and gracious God, that there is no one like you. You are children, my Lord, my Father, the sheep of your pasture. Here we are, not by our own power, not by our own strength, not by our own righteousness, but your grace and mercy, Lord Jesus, that continue to do a great and mighty thing in our life. That is that you counted us among the living this morning. We do not take it for granted. Abba, Father, we can look around our household. No one is missing. Many people, Lord Jesus, slept as we did, but they could not be able to see a new day like this. Father, we thank you. We worship you. Father, Lord, to show, my Lord, my Father, the deepest love that you have for us. You have gathered us this hour, my Lord, my Father, to start the day with you, for us to hear your undiluted word. That word that will keep on propelling us. That word will keep on strengthening us, oh Lord Jesus. And we'll be able to meet you in glory. Abba, Father, we thank you, we worship you. Father, Lord, even as we have gathered this hour, my Lord, my Father, Ancient of Days, our gathering, my Lord, my Father, will be of no value if your Holy Spirit is not in our midst, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, I therefore ask, my Lord, my Father, let your Holy Spirit, our comforter, our teacher, our helper, let him come and take preeminence in our midst this hour. Let him come and incubate us, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus. Our coming before you will not be in vain, my Lord, my Father. That your plan and purpose that you have for each and every son in this mountain, Father, Lord, shall be fulfilled to your own glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My Lord and my Father, I take authority this hour, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, against every principality, every powers of the darkness, every spirit that programmed, my Lord, my Father, slip into the eyes of your children. Father, Lord, we arrest them this hour, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, we command them out of our midst, Lord Jesus. Father, Lord, we direct them into the portal, speak there, they will be forever in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Up to you. I have no power of my own. I have no wisdom of my own. I rely on you. Father, Lord, I'm only a vessel, King of all glory, as it pleases you this morning. Father, Lord, use me to your own glory, Lord Jesus, that at the end, my Lord, my Father, each and every one of us shall be blessed. And all glory, honor, adoration will be unto you and you alone. Blessed be your holy and mighty name. In Jesus Christ's holy name, we have all prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Brethren, this morning, in the short word of exhortation, please, I enjoin us to open our Bible to the book of Hebrew. Book of Hebrew, chapter 3. And I will take our reading from verse 7 to verse 7 to 19. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hebrew chapter 3, from 7 to 19, I read in Jesus' name. He said, wherefore, as the Holy Ghost said, today, not tomorrow, today, this glorious day, today, a new day that we have not experienced before. Today, an emphatic word. Today, if you will hear his voice, 8, harden not your hearts as in the provocation, in the day of the temptation, in the wilderness. 9, when your fathers tempted me, proved me, and saw my works, 40 years. 10, wherefore I was grieved with that generation and said, they do always err in their hearts, and they have not known my ways. So I swore in my wrath that they shall not enter into my rest. 12. Take heed. Take heed, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief, departing from living God. 13. But exhort one another daily while it is called today. Again, lest any of you be hardened through the what? Through the deceitfulness of sin. 14. For we are made partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast unto the end. 15. Why it is said, today, if you hear his voice, harden not your heart as in the provocation. 16. For some, when they had heard, did provoke. Howbeit not all that came out of Egypt by Moses. 17. But with whom was he grieved 40 years? Was it not with them that had sinned, whose carcasses fell in the wilderness? 18. And to whom swore he that they should not enter into his rest, but to them that believed not. 19, our last verse. So we see that they could not enter in. Why? Because of what? Unbelief. Praise Master Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Beloved, the verse 7, where we just read now, he said, today, not tomorrow, if you will hear his voice, today, an emphatic word, today. Why is the Bible emphasizing on it? Today is being expressed strongly and with force to show how important it is today. Because this scripture is inspired by the Holy Spirit. Today means it requires an urgent action and reaction. You know why the Bible is emphasizing? Because we human beings, we have this tendency to delay. We have this tendency of procrastination. More especially when it comes to spiritual matters. When it comes to spiritual matters that is meant to save our souls from the, from what? From damnation. If you take a closer look from where we just read, this short verse of the Bible just read, you will come to discover that today was mentioned 3 times in this short verse that we just read. It was mentioned 3 times. It was mentioned in verse 7. It was mentioned in verse 13. It was mentioned in verse 14. 3 times. Today. The question now is, with all this warning, even in the Bible that we read this morning, the warning of Almighty God has been going on and on. But the people choose to do their own. The Lord now spoke by himself. He said, instead of my blessing, they are going to reap whirlwind. You know what is whirlwind? We have heard what hurricane can do. He said, instead of blessing, they will reap what? Whirlwind. Why? Because Israel have turned their back against their maker. And that is why the word of God is coming this morning. 3 times. Today, not tomorrow. Today, if you hear his word, as you are hearing now, do not harden your heart. Do not procrastinate. Do not say tomorrow. Today, not tomorrow. Why is it? Well, God does not leave his children in darkness. Why is it? When it comes to things that matters, you know, to our souls, this is where we begin, you know, to give excuses. But if we are being given an assignment where we work, where we do our vocation, we do not procrastinate. Today, if you hear his word, if you hear his warning, this is what I want us to ask God. His infinite mercy. What is that in me that always bring procrastination? That always bring delay for me to hit your voice? For me to hit your warning? Father Lord, anything that is in me, even as I am hearing your word today, my Father, anything that will tell me, oh, tomorrow, there is still another time for you to do. Father Lord, today, let that thing be terminated from my life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Bible also reminded us of the need to give a prompt attention and give heed to the undiluted word of God and never allow Satan and his agents to make us to take to light the warning of God. Why? Because every transgression, beloved, every disobedience that is not confessed and repented, definitely they have their dues. Bible angels, do not take to light, do not delay. In the book of the same Hebrew, Hebrew chapter 2, if you read from verse 1 to 4, we have the same. It says, therefore, we ought to give more earnest heed to things which we have heard, as we are hearing that paraphrase, lest at any time we should let them slip. And that is the spirit of the Bible. Even as you are hearing the word, let it slip out of your mind. It does not matter. We begin to just shadow instead of the object. Verse 2. For if the word spoken by the angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense reward. 3. How shall we then escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that had him? It's a question. Verse 4. God also bearing witness, both with signs and wonders, and with divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. That is why this morning, the title of this short message is called, Harden Not Your Hearts. Harden what? Not your hearts. How shall we escape? The Bible said, every disobedience, every transgression that you fail to confess, that you fail to repent of, there is a due reward. No wonder the Bible again said in the book of Romans chapter 6, verse 23, it said, for the wages of sin is what? There is nothing but what? Death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Then why is people hardening their hearts to receive this gift of God? But don't ask God again. Say, Father, King of all glory, every stony heart in me is making me to reject the gift, the free gift that Jesus Christ has brought to save me from damnation, to save me from hellfire. Every stony heart in me, every stony heart in the life of my loved ones, Father, today, let that heart begin to make in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hope you have to ask God this.
Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Father, in the name of Jesus Christ.
My beloved brethren, the best time to respond to God's word, the The best time to respond to God's correction, the best time to respond to God's chastisement and admonishment is what is now. That is why the Bible was given on today. It's now. Because tomorrow may not work, he may not come. Because tomorrow may not come. Apostle Paul said in the book of 2 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 2, he said, for he said, I have had thee in a time accepted, and in the day of salvation have I succored thee. Behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of what? Of salvation. Now, it indicates what? Indicates urgency. Indicates urgency. Beloved, I don't know where you're connected from. I don't know that thing that you are still doing. And the Holy Spirit have convicted you. And the Holy Spirit have made it known to you to desist or to detach yourself from it. But you are still adamant. Satan is still ministering unto you. Devil is still ministering unto you that you are still very young. There is still more years ahead of you. Beloved, his aim is nothing but to delay you to destruction. That is why the Bible is hammering. Today, now, but Satan will be telling you, there is still enough time. There is still time. You are still young. Are you sick? Are you dying tomorrow? And that is what Satan has succeeded to hold humanity to captive. You will bring the message of salvation to people and say, there is still time now. After. Are you sure of your life? Are you sure that tomorrow will surely come? Are you sure? Why do you allow Satan to harden your heart? Are you sure? You better do what? You better make haste. Why do what? Why the sun shines? Because of what? If you fail to do so, if you allow Satan to harden your heart, even as you are hearing the word of God, if you allow Satan to harden your heart, not to do that restriction that the word of God is telling you, not to take your hand off that dirty business you are doing, if you allow Satan to harden your heart, that worldliness, that lifestyle, you know that is ungodly. If you allow Satan to harden your heart, even after hearing the word of Almighty God this morning, rather look at what God said in the book of 2 Thessalonians. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, from verse 8 to 9, he said, in flaming fire, taking vengeance on them that know not God, and that obey not the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. Flaming fire. 9, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his word, of his presence, because they hardened their hearts, because they refused the word of God. Because they refuse the word of God to correct them. They refuse the correction. They refuse the admonition. They refuse everything that the word of God is doing. Brethren, are you still waiting to reap the whirlwind? That God, because they provoke God to anger, where we read this morning, he said, instead of a blessing, they will reap whirlwind. Why? Because they turned their hearts. Why? Because they could not allow my word to correct them. It's our brethren, I want us once again to ask God, Father, King of all glory, my God and my God, as I come to you this morning, anything that is in me that is making me to take offense when the word of God is coming to correct me, when the word of God is coming to save my soul from damnation, my Lord, this morning, let your fire locate, my Lord, my Father, that attitude, that hobby, my Lord, let your fire burn it out of my life in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen. Father, amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, my Father, my Lord,
in the mighty name of Jesus, in the
name of Jesus, Amen.
Of God, when your heart is hardened, when your heart is stony, when your heart is just made by devil, you will always feel offended. You will always be at war with the true word of God. Jesus Christ, when he was explaining the meaning of the parable of the sower, which me and you know very well, when he was explaining that parable to his disciples, he said concerning the seed that was sown on a stony ground. That is in the book of Mark. If you read from the book of Mark chapter 4, from verse 16 to 17, when he was explaining that parable to disciples, he said, and these are the likewise which are sown on a stony ground, on a soil that is hardened, I paraphrase, on a soil that is very strong. Who, when they have heard the word, immediately receive it with what? With gladness. That is what a stony heart can do. A hardened heart. First, they will receive the word with what? With gladness. Verse 17. And have no root in themselves. That which they receive have no root. Why? Because the heart is hardened. It's cemented. They have no root in them. And so, endure for a time. Afterwards, when affliction or persecution arises for the world's sake, what will they do? Immediately, they are offended. Why? Because the word they receive have no root. Because of what? Because the heart is what is hardened. Even as many are hearing the word of God this morning, if Satan have hardened their hearts, that word may go, oh, that's the word of God. Oh, that's why you can go to church. And people will be shouting, oh, man of God, write down. What a word. Oh, right on. Oh, today is wonderful. And you may ask our sister or brother, what did you get from this message? Oh, it was wonderful. Oh, everywhere shakes. But because that word had no roots, that word, the heart is not fettered to be able to assimilate that word of God. Eventually, because God did not promise me and you that this world we are living is a bed of roses. Praise Master Jesus Christ. Definitely.
Hallelujah.
Challenges will come. That is the truth of the word of God that many preachers deny from their members. Challenges will come, brethren. Trials will come. The Bible said, be of good cheer. Why? Because your father have overcome. So because those people who received this word, but the word did not go down, when persecution comes, when little challenges come, they take offended. These are the people who can hear the good word of God. A little challenge, they begin to seek for native doctor. They begin to send money. Ah, please go for me. This is too much. This delay is too much. Why me? They take offense. They become offended. Why? Because the word will not be able to have root. I'm going to ask God again. Father Lord, even as I connect in this mountain, morning, afternoon, night, I am here. Father Lord, anything that is still in me that will not allow your word to penetrate, that will not allow your word to really have root in my life, for me to stand in the day of challenge, for me to stand in the day of persecution, for me not to bring your name to the call. Father Lord, think of all glory. Let that in this morning, let it die from the root in the name of Jesus Christ.
My father,
Amen.
Brethren, hardness of heart is what Satan still uses to make people to still begin to continue to debate. Is this hell they are talking, is it real? Is it real? Can it happen? After Jesus Christ has come and died on the cross for us, we are living in era of what? Of grace. Hardness of heart. Satan is a very big weapon in the heart of Satan. Brethren, the hardness of our heart stirs up God's anger and incurs a severe judgment or discipline. God is not passive when it comes to sin, especially the sin of what? Hardness of heart. You saw what we just read. The same God. That was why a whole generation of people of Israel was wasted in the wilderness. Why? Because of the hardness of their heart against God's warning. If you go to the book of Numbers, Numbers from 14, if you read from verse 20 down, you see the same people that God did wonders, the same people that God did what no man has ever had, the same people that God used his might to be able to rescue from the hand of their slave masters, their taskmasters, from the hand of Pharaoh. The same people, because they had in their hearts, because what they saw, they could not be able to take it in. Their heart was hardened. The same crop of generation, they were all wasted in the wilderness. Why? Because of hardness of heart. When it comes to, you can say, well, we read in the Bible reading, hardness of heart incurred wrath of God. The same God who is merciful, the same God who is gracious and faithful, hardness of heart can make God to come up as what? As what? As a consuming fire. He rose and he consumed them. Why is this one coming to me and you this morning? Look at what the word of God said in the book of 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 10, 11. He said, now, all these things, I paraphrase, all this is we're hearing this morning. All this is that the Bible is saying now. He's not talking about the Israel of old. He's talking about me and you. 1 Corinthians 10, 11. He said, now, all these things are put unto them for example. And they are written for our own words, for our own admonition. Upon whom the ends of the world are to come. Brethren, are you going to wait until that very water, until that very ocean gets to your leg before you begin to run? Are you going to wait for the history of iniquity to repeat itself in your life? We're going to pray this morning. We're going to ask God. He said, all these things happened for them, for example, because they hardened their heart. That was why all the anger of God, all the fear of Almighty God came upon them. Because they hardened their hearts. They could not run away. What the word of God said, run away. Desist. Flee away from every appearance of evil. Hell is real. Hell have enlarged its mouth. People still hardened their hearts. And then this hour, I want us to open our mouth and ask God. Say, Father, by your mercy, by your grace, Lord Jesus, the history of iniquity, like my brother Mali pray here, the history of iniquity. Father Lord, I will not allow it to happen in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, give me the grace. Father Lord, to take in your word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Open your mouth and Lord Father, by your grace, Lord Father, the history of iniquity. I will not allow it in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will not allow it in my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will not allow it in my life. I will not allow it in my family. Give me the grace, oh Lord. Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm drawing the curtain. If you choose to disobey, if you choose to ignore this warning, which means you want the history of what? Of destruction to happen in your life. But I pray that will not be the portion of anyone in this mountain in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Anyone that choose to ignore or to what? To disobey. You are doing that to your own damnation. Finally, the Bible said in the book of John chapter 3 verse 18, it said, he that believeth on me is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already. There are people that are there, they are today living, but they are walking corpse. Because their heart has hardened over the message, over the true word of the gospel of Almighty God. The Bible says, even as they are walking, they are what? A living corpse. They are condemned already. Why? Because of what? The hardness of their hearts. Because they refuse to accept the word of the truth, the word that will be able to deliver them from destruction into the marvelous light of Almighty God. Father, this prayer, I'm going to ask God, Father Lord, you might pray this prayer if we pray it, you know, for your brother or for your sister, or stand in the gap for that your best friend that is still arguing, that Satan is still using to argue. How do you know that this will happen? How do you know? We're going to pray. Say, Father, every spirit of unbelief that has made the heart of your children to be hardened, not to accept the gospel of salvation, not to accept the undeniable word of God, my Lord and my Father, Father Lord, deliver your children from destruction in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hope your mother begin to pray that out.
In the mighty
name of Jesus. As the word of God is coming in this mountain every morning, every afternoon, every night for us, to chastise us, to admonish us, to correct us, so that we can be able to continue this race that every day the road is getting narrow and narrow. Anything that Satan may bring, even in future, to make you to derail, to make me to detach, that thing, the fire of Almighty God will burn it this morning in this mountain in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 This is the warning of the word of God, not my word, for me and for you this morning. And I pray God Almighty will make his word to prosper in your life and in my life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
Are you out there? You have not given your life to Jesus Christ. With your own ears, you have heard from the word of God, not the word of man, what is going to be the reward of anyone that does not have Jesus Christ in his life. So for you to run away from the fury, from the anger of Almighty God, count yourself so privileged to hear his words and the warning this morning. You had better ask him to come into your life. To come and reign, to come and take absolute control, to come and dominate. If the word of God has taught you this morning, you want to give your life unto him, please repeat this word of confession after me. Say, Lord Jesus, through your word, I have heard that my action can provoke you to anger. Who am I to stand your anger, to stand your wrath? Lord, I plead for your mercy. All this while that ignorantly Satan have deceived me not to accept you, not to accept your word, not to accept your warning. But today, oh Lord Jesus, your word have really knocked at the door of my heart. Here I am, I've opened for you, oh Lord Jesus. come into my life. Take away every stony heart that has been making me to argue your word foolishly. Today, O Lord Jesus, I accept you into my life as my Lord and personal Savior. Take total and absolute control of my life. Reign in my life. Let your word always correct me. Let your word always admonish me. Let your word chastise me into your kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Through your mercy and grace, let my name be taken away from the book of death and write my name in the book of life. Keep me until you are coming. In Jesus Christ's mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Greater prayer. Heaven is celebrating concerning your soul. And we in this matter of Almighty God welcome you. And you begin to see the goodness and mercy of Almighty God upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray with you. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Ancient of Days, as many, oh Lord Jesus, Father, Lord, King of all glory, that your word have touched this hour, and as many that will still hear this word, my Lord, my Father, Lord Jesus, that your word have convinced them, my Lord, my God, that they have been, Lord Jesus, playing, my Lord, my Father, playing card with their precious soul. Father, Lord, today, through your warning, Lord Jesus, they have confessed you as their Lord and personal Savior. They have repented, my Lord, my Father, of their evil ways, of their evil, my Lord, my Father, King of all glory, argument of your word. Today, they have accepted your word, my Lord, my Father. Lord Jesus, in your infinite mercy, may you accept them, my Lord, my Father. Blot away their name from the book of death, write their name in the book of life, Lord Jesus. Father, keep them to their coming, my Lord, my Father. Let your name be glorified in your life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. For in Jesus Christ's holy name, we have all prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, I give you glory. I give you honor, my God. Father, Lord, what a privilege I have, oh Lord Jesus. What an opportunity that are given to me, my Lord, my Father, to speak your word unto your children. Father, Lord, I do not know more than any of them. It is not a privilege. Lord Jesus, I thank you. I worship you. I give you all the glory and honor. Father, your word that you have spoken unto me and unto your children, Lord Jesus, Father, King of all glory, the grace for us to take in the admonishment and the chastisement of your word, Father, Lord, we receive that grace this morning. Every spirit in us that is still making us, my Lord, my Father, to challenge or to argue your word foolishly, Father, Lord, that spirit have died this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, let not your word, Father, Lord, stand against me nor against your children. Let your word continually, my Lord, my Father, correct, propel us and lead us unto the right path of life and to be able to meet you in glory in your kingdom in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, Lord, have I spoken your word out of context, my Lord, my Father? Father, Lord, every error of omission or commission, Father, Lord, I ask for your mercy in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your name be glorified and magnified. For in Jesus Christ's holy name, I have all prayed with thanksgiving.
Amen. Yes.
Master Jesus Christ.
Bishop of a soul, Shepherd of a soul,
Savior of a soul, Lover of a soul.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcome. We will never give up.